Hello, everybody. This is your live streamer, Freeman Sullivan, live streaming from downtown Oakland here. We're out here for the Black Friday 14. We're at the Alameda County Superior Courthouse, and everybody's showing up here. There's a crowd of about 25 to 30 people, and we'll be out here for the next hour or so. We're out here to get District Attorney Nancy O'Malley to drop the charges against the Black Friday 14, which are 14 members of the Blackout Collective, which performed an action last year and stopped the BART trains from running at West Oakland BART station. Nobody was hurt during this time. It's a minor inconvenience for people that were using BART, but there was really no criminal activity. And another reason that I was moved to come out here today was also in solidarity with the people of Chicago, Laquan, McDonald's, and also in solidarity with Jamar Clark in Minneapolis, because the Minneapolis police have proven themselves to be total bastards. We know that the Chicago police, we already know already that they're already bastards, so we don't gotta go too far on that one. And we're out here to support Black Lives Matter. So if you're tweeting out, please use the hashtag #DropTheCharges or #BlackFriday14. So we're just getting started here, and so please be patient. If you would log on to the chat, and if anybody would like, and let me know how the audio visual looks, I would very much appreciate that. So I'm going to try and sit down as long as I can. My back is really hurting right now. You know, it's tough getting old. That's all I can tell you. And being disabled. That looks like more and more people are showing up. This is an interface ceremony. For more information, I don't have the URL. I'll just go on Facebook and look for Black Friday 14. And you should be able to find more information about this event, about what's going on. Or if you check my timeline on my tweets, you should be able to find the link. So we'll move in as soon as something happens here. Pretty quiet at the moment. Just a bunch of people milling around. And I must admit that there's no guarantee how long I'm going to be out here. It has more to do with the way my back feels than anything. Okay, some people are starting to speak, so I guess I'll move closer. Again, for people that are just joining us, this is your live streamer, Freeman Sullivan, streaming from Oakland, California at the Alameda County Superior Courthouse. Come down and join us if you're in and around the Bay Area and downtown. We'll be out here until approximately 3 p.m. And we're just getting started here. So give us a few minutes. Hang on. Log on to the chat. Let me know how the audiovisual is coming out. I'd very much appreciate that. Looks like we're going to have a pretty good crowd. This is an interfaith rally in support of the Black Friday 14, who were arrested for stopping BART last year, the day after Thanksgiving, to protest in solidarity with the people of Ferguson. And they're facing charges. And we're trying to get the district attorney, Nancy O'Malley, who's a very corrupt individual, to, of course, when are they not? Drop the charges. And please bear with me, I am disabled, so if I happen to get really tired, my back's bugging me. You'll know why when I stop the broadcast. It's not that I don't want to keep live streaming, it's just that sometimes it gets physically impossible for me to. Well, we're going to hang out as long as we can. Looks like we've got a nice crowd of people out here. Some familiar faces. I always like it when I go to a rally when I don't know hardly anybody. Because generally around the Bay Area, I've been covering demonstrations for so many years now where if I go to a demonstration, I actually know the organizers. So this is a little new territory for me. And I was motivated to come out here just basically in solidarity with all the Black Lives Matters protests that have been going around the country, in solidarity with Laquan McDonald, who was murdered by Chicago police last year, and the Chicago city government managed to keep it covered up for a year. And he was murdered in cold blood. Also, in solidarity with the people of Minneapolis who are suffering because of the death of Jamar Clark and the fact that white supremacists attacked the people that were protesting there. And so I decided I'm coming out, and we're not going to let these white supremacists and these freaking Nazis like Donald Trump like try to scare us into not, you know, fighting for our rights. I mean, that's why we're out here today. Let's make no mistake about it, Donald Trump is a Nazi. You know, he might look all Hollywood and all that, but guys got to remember, right, just listen to what he says and not how he looks. So I'd like to thank you all for joining us. And we should be getting started here in a few minutes, so the less you hear of me and the more you hear of these people, the better. I did see a couple of familiar faces, of course.
Turn around, 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 tur talking, marching to freedom land.
I say, I say.
Greetings, everyone. It's so good to see your wonderful faces today. I am Priestess Akinu, and I'm your mistress of ceremonies today. And I'm so glad to be here and to see you and be in this struggle with you and to be in this celebration with you. Who's ready to support and celebrate the Black Friday 14? Who's ready to tell O'Malley what she should already know to do what?
Drop the charges.
Who does not know what happened on November 28th? Okay, so on November 28th, the Black Friday 14 courageously and in love expressed their freedom and justice by chaining themselves to the BART in protest of racial discrimination, in protest of the war on black lives, in protest of need we go further on now, all the sins of white supremacy. And so, in doing so, now they are being criminalized by the district attorney's office for standing up for justice. And not only are they being criminalized, but they're being selectively prosecuted. Which is not just. It's in retribution, and it's punitive, and it's pure racism. Yep. And so we want O'Malley to do what?
Drop the charges!
Exactly. On December 10th, November 10th, 14 laborers did exactly what we're doing here today on the other side of this building in support of the Black Friday 14. And now we've come together today, 14 plus interfaith leaders, to tell O'Malley to do what?
Drop the charges!
Yes, so today you will hear from members of the Black Friday 14 who can be able to be present. You will hear from different faith leaders speaking from their tradition in support of this and also in celebration of. So we want to do both. We don't want to just say O'Malley dropped the charges, but we also want to create sustainable resilience and support and love on and celebrate on the people who so courageously demonstrated freedom and justice in action. Amen?
Amen.
So that's what we're here to do. And so we're going to do that in using our voices, using songs, using chants. And you are part of this. We're all part of this in community. If you have a song that's on your heart and we have time for it, we want to do that. We're going to ask our wonderful faith leaders who can often preach a while to stay to the time limit of 5 minutes, because we are committed to having a 2-hour service, because we have people with different abilities and different capacities to be out here, and so we want to honor that. So please be mindful, so if everyone can participate, we really need you to stick to your time, and also lovingly remind you if you're going over time. Okay? So we want O'Malley to do what?
Drop the charges!
Okay. Where's Lou? Oh, excuse me. Pastor Aunt is going to come. Some words.
Sego Aguego, Patricia Tano Ikopeshli Ichiwin Yunyats. Hi everybody, my name is Patricia. In the Mohawk tradition, every time we gather to celebrate anything, we begin with the Ohondon Kariwadego, which is the words before all else. And so today we begin this celebration of the Black Friday 14 and the movement for resistance with the words before all else. I'm going to read them. I'm just learning Mohawk language because it was illegal for so long. And so I'm going to read the kindergarten version of the Mohawk with the middle school translation of the English. And this process can take up to 3 days in Mohawk country. And so I'm going to try to keep it to the 5 minutes. Panjogwa, sewa tahunjos, konikariwesa, tano tonsitewa no eradome, sunkoyati son negadi, ne ohondo kariwatego. Let us stop and stand together and listen for a wee bit as we share these words of love, greetings, and thanksgiving for all creation. Agrego onska, onzi te wano ni ne onguani gura, tano diete nu erado ne, ongua soa ne agrego skono, akanage ti tianoe I yonhonsa. Let us gather up all our minds and bundle them up as one mind as we send love, greetings, and gratitude to all of the people gathered here. Let us send love out to people everywhere, that peace may always prevail as we mingle here together on Mother Earth. Eden adunhakne ungwani gura, and now our minds are one. And so when I say Eden adunhakne ungwani gura, the response is to. Agwego onska onji de wanoni ne ongwani gura. Tano tihete nu werado ne yesti yeti nesto a ohunja. Let us now send love, greetings, and gratitude to our mother, the earth, because she gives us all we need to flourish. Tihete nu werado ne onegaso a Sego yonkwa tiana tos tano tieti nu era done konjon soa. Let us turn our thoughts to the waters of the world that keep us clean and quench our thirst and make life possible. Let us greet and thank the fish who the Creator gave the job of keeping the waters clean. With gratitude and love, we greet them. Tieti nu era done. Tieti nu era done. Ohunja soa, tano otera soa, tano onungwa soa. And now we greet with gratitude the grasses and plants that create a beautiful green cover for Mother Earth, and thank the roots who hold them steady, and send our greetings out to the medicine plants that heal us when we are sick. Tieti nu era done tione kwa tonkwa yona aso nikotake ononsta osate tano ononsera tano kahi soe soa. Let us now send love, greetings, and gratitude to all the foods that sustain us, especially the three sisters, corn, beans, and squash. And also the fruits and berries, especially the leader of the berries, the strawberry, the big medicine after a long winter. Agrego onska onjite wanoni ne ungwani gura, tano tieti nu era done, otsiton wa soa. And now we send our love, greetings, and thanks to all the insects. Some are crawling on the ground or cleaning our soil. Others are flying through the air, pollinating the flowers so that food can grow to nourish us. Tieti nu era done con tirio. Tano taque carias, tano te wat vistos. To all the wild animals everywhere who help us when we were hungry and cold, we send you love and gratitude for always reminding us how we were meant to live. Edono dunhakne ungwani gura. Tieti nu era done onguiro soa, tano koronto sunha. And let us now thank all the trees everywhere for creating the air and giving us shade and wood, and especially the leader of the trees, the maple, who brings sweetness to our lives and heals our heart. We now greet the birds and thank all the winged ones for always sharing with us their songs and music to lift our hearts when we are sad and remind us how blessed we are to be alive. And now we greet our grandfathers, the thunderers, and the beautiful lightning, and the four winds that blow across the world, with love and gratitude, for they clean the air and bring us beautiful rain, without which there can be no life. Gratitude and love to you all. Edo no dunhak ne in guanigura. Tonsi te wano wera done sunkwayat ti kyokenega karagua. Let us now send love and greetings to our older brother, the sun, the light of the daytime sky, thanking him for lighting the earth so that we can see and keeping us warm as we travel on Mother Earth. And now we shall greet our grandmother, the moon, the light of the nighttime sky, who regulates the cycles of the women and watches over the children, including those yet unborn, the seven generations still to come. We also send gratitude to the beautiful stars who fill our skies with sparkling jewels for our grandmother to wear. And now we gather our minds together to greet with gratitude all of the enlightened beings, the star dwellers, the sacred teachers and leaders who come to Earth during times of discord when people lose their way. They help us to return to a good path and remember our original instructions. And so in this moment we remember and send love and thanks to the Black Friday 14. Eto no dunhak ne unguani gura. Tonsite wana werado ne sun kwayati son ne wahirano aguego sinahodun tiekin wenera ohunsta. And now we send our greetings, love, and gratitude to the Creator who has given us the gift of life and all the gifts of creation. We have now opened up our time together with the Thanksgiving address. If in these words I have forgotten anything, it is not my intention. So I ask each of you silently to add in anything I may have forgotten so that our collective gratitude can go out fully in a good way to all parts of creation. Aguego onska onchite wane. And now together, let us gather up all of our greetings and gratitude and love into one big bundle and release it up into the sky, thanking the Creator for this beautiful gathering today. Edo no dunhak ne unguani gura. Do nyo wanage. That's all the words for now.
Good afternoon, I'm Lou Flores. Awo Ifa Dunsing. I represent Orisha tradition, Ifa. I'm a Shango priest, and I'm here to pour libations for us and the ancestors, to bring in the coolness, to bring in the calmness, to bring in the blessings that all our ancestors have been praying for. In these traditions, we actually stand and kneel on the earth in order to do this type of ceremony. So for those who are capable and want to join me, I am going to kneel. So I asked permission from all the elders present to do this libation. I'm going to start in Yoruba and then translate into English, okay? Omi tutu, ona tutu, tutu ile, tutu ori, tutu eshu, tutu orisha, tutu leroye. Kosi iku, kosi oro, kosi ofo, kosi arun, kosi fitibo, kosi idina, kosi ek, ba, kosi ese, kosi eyo. Ariku bagoa, ariku yoa. Mojuba ebeye egun bogbo, mojuba bogbo ndelesi rotu mare, mojuba ara arun ile ori ebe egun. Mojuba olofi, mojuba olorun, mojuba rotu mare. Kika mashe in Ita the Lara Tia Santa, Kika mashe in Fashina at Elijah, Kika mashe all the ears and babas of Ile Oriag Beegun, Kika mashe Baba Ifa Karade, Kika mashe Epatevi Sequoia Karade, Kika mashe Baba Lama Malamo Beyeton Tono, Kika mashe Yake Beyeton Tono, Kika mashe Adafumi or Sedaman the First, His Royal Highness Beyeton Tono, Kika mashe all the ears and babas and medicine holders and all the tradition. And all the traditions present, we ask permission to do these libations. We bring in cool waters, fresh waters, calm waters. We ask that the roads be open to hear our prayers. We ask that all the ancestors who sit on the right of the great creator to stand with us and uplift us this day and every day of our lives. We ask all the divine beings, all the spirits, all the orisha to stand and give witness to this ceremony, to give witness to our prayers, to lift us up this day. We ask on behalf of all the people present from the great creator, hear our call, hear our call, hear our call, and rise up and stand with us. Yes. Stand with us every yes. day of our lives. Fight this injustice. Yes. Fight and uplift us, yes. divine beings. Yes. Ashe, 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 oh ashe.
Ashe,
oh. Thank you.
Rabbi Lynn Button.
Yes.
Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum assalam.
Shalom aleichem.
Shalom aleichem.
Peace be with you. I am honored to offer an invocation before you. Yivane Beit HaShchina, Yivane Beit HaShchina, Yivane Beit HaShchina, Bimhera. This invocation be acceptable in the eyes of the Holy One and in the hearts of everyone who is gathered here. Breath of Life, we are here today to offer an invocation and to invoke the call that we have been awakened to by Black Lives Matter as we say together this invocation. Black Lives Matter.
Black Lives Matter.
The invocation for justice in our hearts and minds. The invocation, Black Lives Matter. We are here today as faith-rooted people, and in my tradition, in a prophetic tradition, in a tradition that sees injustice and reminds us that the path to the Creator is not through mindless piety, but to acting in behalf of what is harming people, to act to change injustice. We are here to testify that the core of our religious traditions teach us how to be faithful by pursuing justice and well-being. And we are here to say, Black Lives Matter. We are here to remind John McPartland and Nancy O'Malley and all of faith-based America and white people everywhere who claim that religion is their foundation stone You can make a choice. Religion calls you to make a choice. You can make a choice. You are not powerless. You can make a choice to stop criminalizing, prosecuting, incarcerating, and killing black people. You can say no. You can say
Black Lives Matter.
As Faith Rudy people, we invoke the core teaching of our spiritual traditions, and we say, erecting, maintaining, and justifying racist institutions that harm and kill fellow human beings, this is sinful. Remaining silent is sinful. Being complicit is sinful. Love is demonstrated by our actions in behalf of justice, not by our words, by our actions. And we say,
Black Lives Matter.
As people rooted in the faith of Black Lives Matter, which has called on the United States to transform its soul, we heed the call to rise up and build this movement from New York to Oakland, Chicago to Baltimore, Cleveland to Ferguson, and from Ferguson to Raqqa, and from Raqqa to Baghdad, Aleppo, and Shajaya. We direct our hearts and hands to keep working for the time. Racism is a distant memory. Reparations have been paid the African American community for the sin of slavery. The police have been demilitarized, and communities are empowered with democracy and good governance. And dreamers can dream without fear. We pray together. We join hands together. We honor Black Lives Matter. Amen.
So we have a question for O'Malley. You know what the question is?
Which side are you on?
Which side are you on? O'Malley needs to do what?
Drop the charges.
We're gonna have Molly come up with an announcement right now. Yes.
Hello, everyone. So it is beautiful to see all of you here, and I wanted to include you in case people haven't already heard yet. I wanted everyone here to feel included, to know, you know, as part of the action, and also to know what is happening just on the other side of the front doors right there in the courtroom, which is we have 14 interfaith leaders in there doing another direct action. They're not on the second, that's right. Let's cheer, why don't you cheer loud enough so they can hear? That's right. They wanted me to let them know when I made the announcement, so y'all did it for me. We let them know the announcement has been made. And just, you know, tagging on to that, it's wonderful to see all of you here. We can also use these wonderful things we have, our phones, our iPads, whatever you brought with you, to tweet out what is happening. These 14 interfaith leaders there represent not only themselves, they represent their whole communities. Whole communities, just like on November 10th when we had 14 labor leaders sitting in, who represented not only themselves and where they stand, which side they are on, but they were representing tens of thousands of their constituents, of their members. Same thing with these labor leaders. They are sitting in there bravely right there in the lobby, and you can probably make it through the security, you know, go in, take pictures, take videos, tweet out, Facebook out, Instagram out, all that, what's happening. And you can use, you know, not to make it like it's all about social media, but hey, that's where we've gotten where we are now, when people were defying the mainstream media and the narrative that they've been trying to tell. And so we have another narrative, and that is that Black Lives Matter. You can use that hashtag. You can use hashtag Black Friday 14. And the other reason why we're here, hashtag drop the charges. This is all happening because 14 black activists are facing charges. That's not what our action was about, though. It wasn't about us going to jail, and it wasn't about us staying out of jail. It was about lifting up what happened the message of, you know, the injustice that happens not only here in Oakland, not only in Ferguson, not only in New York, but across the nation, everywhere. That's right, in Chicago. We are lifting up the message that Black Lives Matter and that we as a community here in Oakland are standing up against that. And today, we have our faith leader standing up. I am so incredibly grateful. I feel so incredibly blessed to see everyone here and to know that everyone is out there. I can't even explain how full my heart is. The day that the nation has called Thanksgiving is tomorrow. It's actually today. I am so thankful.
We want to release O'Malley from being wrong, because this is not about right or wrong. We want to release her and any ego involved and being wrong. This is simply about justice. This is about deep, committed love. This is about an innate sense of freedom that you're willing to put your bodies on the line. That's what we're talking about. And it goes beyond right or wrong. So O'Malley, we're not saying that you're wrong. We're saying what?
Drop the charges!
Drop the charges!
You're right.
You're right. And we're gonna bring up our Reverend Tony Dunbar to give us a word. And before she does so, our youth, you know our youth are leading us. So we have a youth, Octavia, who has stepped up to say, I'll be timekeeper, and when people have 1 minute left, I'll do this, and when they have 30 seconds left, I'll do this. Isn't she brilliant? Yeah. I know she got there somewhere, but she put it in this context, and so thank you, Octavia.
I'm Tony Dunbar. My church is called City of Refuge, United Church of Christ. We don't stand for it. Wherever it raises its head, somebody from my church is there to say, oh no.
That's right.
And I'm going to speak to you today, not from a formal invocation position, but from the tradition of the Black family table, where we sit around and we kind of palaver. We just talk about it, you know, at the barbecue, you know, at the dinner. And from the Black church, where we sort of want to talk about it, and then we come to a conclusion, and then that conclusion sends our feet out onto the street. Part of it is extemporaneous, part of it is written, but all of it is personal and it comes from the heart. So let me start out by saying, if one side of this conversation is about money, it's very definitely about money. But the other side is about life. Yeah, see, the other side is about life. Now, for example, Bart wants to get paid for lost fares, but it doesn't want any accountability for lost lives. Rest in peace and then rise in power, and I'm going to name some names. Gerald Hall, Black man, 1992. Bruce Seward, Black man, 2001. Oscar Grant, Black man, 2009. Fred Collins, mixed Black man, 2010. Robert Greer, Black man, 2010. Fred Collins, Black man, 2010. Charles Hill, white man, 2011. And in an extraordinary act of internal incompetence, Tom Smith, white man, 2014. Of the 7 men I just named, 5 are Black, 2 or maybe 3 were mentally ill. Of the 2 white men, one was homeless, and the other one was a BART police officer killed by so-called friendly fire. In other words, 6 of the 7 men fit the profile. 6 of the 7 men fit the description. And the other one was an accident. Bart's been using what Cornell Brooks, who is the president and the CEO of the NAACP, called the problematic warrior style of policing versus the guardian mode of policing. And it's about money.
That's right.
Just like that recent strike was about money.
That's right.
I want us to have in mind that in 2012, Bart's utility workers, who are the lowest paid employees, still average over $78,000 a year in salaries and benefits. Now that's more than most people riding BART.
That's right. Well,
and maybe it's true that BART employees hadn't had a raise in 5 years, but the fares for the riders have increased every year since 2003.
Yes, they have.
More increases are scheduled. And oh, by the way, in 2012, and I need you to, somebody that can do this math with the 2.5% per year, in 2012, BART Police Services salaries and benefits averaged over $166,000 a year in salaries and benefits. These are the men who've been killing other men with impunity and absolutely no accountability to the community. We haven't even touched on municipal and private policing. So I'm almost down. I'm bringing nothing really to this fight but my body. When I was young, I would have argued for violence and retribution over the hundreds of deaths and the thousands of acts of police brutality across our nation. Today I'm old, and I know that war is not the answer, and that change comes slowly through persistence. By the time the change comes to BART, and even by the time O'Malley and all the rest of them stand up and say, yes, I made the correct decision, by the time that happens, some of this Black Friday 14 will have been forgotten unless it's through persistence that we keep them in the public eye. They're receiving this draconian treatment because they fit the profile.
That's right.
All right.
Because they fit the profile. If Black lives matter, allies' lives matter, and the future lives matter, we have to be persistent and vigilant and strategic and unafraid.
Yes, yes.
Maybe laying down on the tracks somewhere in my future, but I know that being victimized and afraid is deeply in my past.
All right.
I trust God and the arc of justice to guide our feet. That's why there are 14 people inside and what, 60, 75 people outside. That's why we're not taking it. In the name of whatever God we claim, whatever God we serve, in the name of whatever God we acknowledge and recognize, we're not taking it. My Lord and my God, I love you so much. And I love you for bringing out each one of these, for putting it out in the air that we're not taking it. Black lives matter. Allies' lives matter. All lives matter. Future lives matter. Our children matter and should not grow up with this same thing happening day by day.
Amen.
We thank you because you will see the justice, even if it takes what we call a long time. When it comes, it'll be perfect and permanent. And we pledge to you our persistence. We will not quit until we see justice alive and well on the earth. Now thank you and bless each one and everything with which they have to do. In the name of the great and most divine. Amen.
Amen.
Ashe.
Ashe.
Namaste.
Namaste.
Inshallah.
Inshallah.
Shalom.
Shalom.
Be in peace.
Do y'all feel loved up?
Yeah.
We're all loved up right now. Thank you. That's good. And what you say? We're not taking it. I like that.
That's right.
Oh, in this love energy that we're experiencing right now, want to bring up members of the Black Friday 14 that were able to be here today.
Okay, that's what I want.
Warrior, if you can come up.
Yay!
Absolutely, keep the love coming.
faith community who are so inclined and who are prepared to... Can you hear me?
That was it for the scheduled speakers.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Okay. We're going to ask members of the faith community, people that are prepared to bless these love warriors, these freedom fighters, at this particular time, and we're going to ask Terry. Terry's here, Reverend Dunbar's here. Is anyone else here who would like to do a blessing? Sophia? Yes. You can come up. There's no scarcity on blessings. We have an abundance of love and blessings around here. If we can just surround them.
Cover this.
And this blessing is not only for them, but it's extended to all of the 14.
In the place of baptism, rebirth, rejuvenation, and the call to lead. I want to bless you, to love you, to thank you, to give you gratitude for the work that has been done and that you are about to do in the many names of your people. The ashes of fire, and it saves, it clears the air and blesses the people. I want to bless you with the power of fire to continue in your life in self-determination. The fire to continue in your life, never turning back from the call about who you really are. Yes, you should rest from time to time. Yes, you should rest from time to time. But I am blessing you with the fire and the ashes, like the phoenix, that you would rise. Anything that tries to oppress you, and that you will always live and stand in the power of your own heart, your own mind, and the Creator. Amen.
Your ancestors, and I call on your ancestors to bless you this day. May they honor the sacrifices that you have made to be released from bondage, to be released from all the things that keep you from your highest good. We ask your ancestors to bless you. Ashe, 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 Ashe.
You have to keep it on.
Assalamu alaikum.
Shalom.
In the tradition of Islam, there's one prayer that we say for all occasions that suits every situation. And I would like to recite that now on your behalf. And I will recite it in Arabic. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillahirrahmanirrahim. Yadikiyamdun. Yahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahmadiyahm things. They're not really looking at where we're going. It essentially says to stay on the right path. And you guys are on the right path. You took the right path when you did what you did. You're going to lead us all to victory with your bravery. And I thank you.
In Umbanda, we recognize the different paths of the Ishus and the Pombajuas, those who can open the roads to us, those whom we turn to and plead to when we seek justice, when justice has been taken from our hands, when we are not allowed to voice our own needs, when we are not allowed to speak truth
to request and to demand the reparations, to request and to demand that the rights be corrected in our favors when we know that we have been truly wronged. I pray and I ask and I light the sacred fires within for Ashu and for Pombajira in all of their many faces and all of their many paths to join with the call to your ancestors, to join with all the spirits, all of the Orisha who wish to join with us, who stand with us and who stand with you and within you. May your feet always, always rock their path. May your hands always do their work. May your voices always speak their truth. And may your heart always carry their strength and their love and their guidance for everything you do and with every breath you take until there is no breath left.
Thank you. And many of you who did not get a chance to speak and had the blessings beaming their way with your love and your energy and your heart, those were received, and keep those coming.
Ashe.
Ashe.
I gotta sit down, I'm sorry. After standing for nearly an hour. Sorry about that. Ooh, my leg was cramping up, folks, sorry. Sorry about that, guys and gals. A brief seat here, and then I'll get back up. My back is killing me. I even took some Lexicon. Still killing me. So, thank you for watching, folks. I think I'm going to have to end the live stream, unfortunately. A little tired, fatigued here, but thank you for watching, and I will be back again on Friday. Tomorrow's Thanksgiving, of course. Everybody have a wonderful Thanksgiving, and don't forget to give thanks to those things in your life that are the most important. Anyway, this is Freeman Sullivan signing off. Much love and much peace to everybody. And again, I'm sorry, but you know, being disabled, my body can only take so much standing. But I love you, and I'll see you soon.